Blackstone presents Swift and Hawk Undercover by Logan Macx. This book is read by Raphael Corkhill. For Tally and Sharko. Chapter 1. Swift and Hawk to the rescue. This was an emergency. Caleb Quinn and Zen Rafiq, codenamed Swift and Hawk, were strapped into the seats of a specially converted Aston Martin, watching the British countryside race by at close to 100 miles per hour. They were heading for a research facility in Cambridge, owned by the American robotics company Soltech. Some kind of cybersecurity breach had occurred, and their mission, as Professor Clay had explained to them back in London, was to stop an embarrassing mess from turning into a very public disaster. Caleb and Zen both went to a special computing and technology school called the ARC Institute, which stood for AI, Robotics, and Cybertech. A few months earlier, they'd been recruited into the Merbius program, a secretive organization run by Professor Clay, the ARC's deputy principal, that used the unique skills of the ARC's pupils to solve high-tech spy problems. Today, Clay had personally taken them out of their morning classes and scrambled them into one of the ARC's prototype electric cars.
"Why are we helping Soltech exactly?" Caleb had asked.
"It's a favor," Clay had replied. "Call for backup if you need it. Mr. Mitchell will get you there."
And it was Lance Mitchell who was now at the wheel of the car, weaving in and out of the regular highway traffic with incredible precision, anticipating gaps and accelerating into empty lanes, all at heart-stopping speed. Mitch, as everyone called him, was the new head of security at the ARC Institute. 6'4", white, with a square jaw and short dark hair. He'd been a US Navy SEAL and then a special agent with the CIA, before going freelance at the age of 47. The tires squealed as the car flew across three lanes, racing down the hard shoulder. Caleb could not stop himself from wincing and grabbing at the dashboard. He glanced in the rearview mirror. Zen was reading the briefing Clay had given them at the ARC, completely unconcerned.
"You know," he said, "I think it would be way better if this was a self-driving car."
Mitch grinned as he eased back into the middle lane between two tractor trailers.
"Welcome to old school ops, kid. Back in the day, we solved all our problems with gasoline and guns."
He stood hard on the accelerator.
"Let's give this baby some gas."
"It's an electric car, Mitch," Caleb said. "There is no gas."
"And your generation didn't solve any problems," said Zen from the back seat, without looking up. "You just made everything 10 times worse."
Mitch shook his head.
"You ARC kids, you're too smart for your own good."
He yanked at the wheel and dragged them down the outside of a luxury bus. The gap between it and the barrier was almost too tight, but they shot through before it could close any farther.
"If this is how you handle our security," Caleb said, "I'd hate to see you on a reckless streak."
An even, synthesized voice spoke through the car's speakers.
"Our journey would be 17 minutes faster if we exited at the next police ramp."
It was Sam, Caleb's artificial intelligence program. The name was short for Simulated Autonomous Medic. Sam had originally been coded by Caleb's dad, Patrick, as a medical AI. After his dad passed away 2 years ago, Caleb had significantly upgraded and expanded the program. Sam mostly interacted with the world via a special handset Caleb had made, which he called the Flex.
"This route leads through the back of a farm," Sam continued, "and then along some very minor roads, but we would avoid a considerable amount of congestion ahead."
"Let's do it," Caleb said. "We need all the time we can get."
Mitch was now tailgating a plumber's van with some intensity.
Please don't tell me that we're going to let that Alexa thing of yours give us directions.
Be nice, Mitch, Caleb said. Sam is 1,000 times more sophisticated than Alexa and Siri put together. The ramp is 500 feet ahead, the AI said, just off the hard shoulder.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.